烟熏牛胸肉、烟熏牛小排、各式 BBQ 烟熏烤炉、牛仔和牛群，吃不完的牛肉、牛肉、牛肉，你会想到什么？当然是美国德州烟熏文化。我保证，本片是台湾 YouTuber 自制，探讨最深入、吃的最多、揭开最神秘面纱的德州烟熏牛肉影片。这次我们亲访美国牛肉故乡之旅，第一站在芝加哥 Chicago。 刚来的第一天就吃遍了六家芝加哥的美食餐厅，内容当然是以牛肉为主角了。
吃什么呢？ Beef Tartar。
好，今天我们来到美国的精品肉商 Meats by Links，
他们为全美各大，不是全世界各大的干式牛排餐厅提供客制服务。
全美最大的 dry aging room， 它不是一个房间，它是一个工厂或者是一个大仓库。
There are 30,000 plus individual cuts of meat in here。
我们是吃了20天、30天，还有60天干式熟成的纽约客，哪一种最好吃呢？
从20天、30天，还有60天，喜欢哪一个？
我喜欢越久的越好。60天刚刚好，它的湿度、它的风出可以做最好的 dry age。
第二站来到德州奥斯汀，
我们有德州奥斯汀的朋友吗？听说在这里 Style Switch BBQ 很有名，今天我们就来看一下。
今天由 Lance Kirkpatrick Style Switch 的 Pitmaster 烧烤大师来为我们介绍，他有24年的烧烤经验。哇，这个是飞弹还是烟熏烤炉啊？
They're propane tanks. These are 1,000 gallon. The guy that welds them, he does them in various sizes. He'll do 1,000 gallon, 500 gallon, 250s. You know, that's how he does his sizes on the pit. It's become very popular. I would say probably in the last 10 years. And there's a lot of places around the country that are doing Texas style and using these type of pits for sure. And that's what's cool about this industry. We get to be back here all night. I got here at 2 a.m. My buddy got here at 3. So we're cooking, let's see, well, we're cooking anywhere from 80 to 120 briskets a night. It's a white oak, post oak, 18 to 20 inch, so they fit in the fireboxes. They're aged out a good 6 to 9 months for us. Indirect smoker is what they're referred to, meaning that your heat source is indirectly located to your protein. The chimney is used to pull it. The height of the chimney is important. To get a good draw is what that would be referred to. You can see the lean of the flame is even leaning in that direction. And it's pulling all of that smoke, right? It's like a convection oven versus a, and it'll slow that convection down and it actually will lower the temp. The brilliant thing about these machines is how it can take a consistent temperature throughout the pit. And one of the things that helps do that is the way the chimney is designed. And it's centrally located at the end of the pit like this, coming out, and it narrows in there, you know what I mean? Like it like a funnel would, so it becomes stronger. There's a math equation for that. Right. Sometimes you'll see barbecue pits that have the chimney setting at the top.
Right.
You always have a hot spot right here because your air is going there to go out. And the cool thing about it, your grate level is right in line with the center of the chimney there. So it's pulling all the heat. Oh, and look at that. That's about ready. We're going to have to pull these off in just a second. And then you'll notice down at this end, it's kind of referred to as the exchange from where the firebox comes into the cooking section, right? So it's cut in a unique way where the heat is kind of encouraged to come up.
Oh, come up. Okay.
See how the bottom is left uncut, so the top of that is kind of cut. So I'd encourage that to come right up this way. There is a little bit of a hotter spot towards the chimney where it pulls down there. So sometimes my bigger items like the beef ribs will be there. Center of it, there is a little bit of a drag in that convection. So your temperature will be slightly lower. So I've got the pork belly there, so it's not too hot.
对于很多德州烧烤店，中午就卖完了全部烤肉，他有简单解决方案。
Being one of the guys that sells out early, just cook more food. You know, just make more barbecue. So that's been our mantra all through. We weren't going to sell out. We were going to serve dinner with barbecue, and a lot of good barbecue is lunch only around here because they sell out.
So what makes a Texas barbecue?
Beef primarily, you know, using beef in barbecue. I think, you know, back in the origins of this style of cooking, a lot of the cattle were coming up from South America and Mexico, and they came right through Texas. And all of the early cattle drives and everything came through here. And I think that's why beef is so prevalent on the menu still here. All of the pork and the pigs and stuff kind of hit the Louisiana, Georgia, all the South Coast on the boats and ships. I don't know. That's what I've always thought, you know.
And how is Texas barbecue different from, say, Carolina?
Well, there's different things about it. You're often gonna see a dry rub on the brisket without any sauce while the cooking process is going on. Sauce will be added after. Dry rub, no sauce. Really just beef being the mainstay of the menu. The cooking style with these indirect smokers. You're starting to see a few more of the cabinet smokers and rotisseries come in. As popularity's grown in barbecue, you know, people are doing more numbers and it's easier in those big cabinet smokers. So a lot of guys are turning to those.
来到外面发现还有更多的超大型烟熏炉，每一个都有名字，像真人一样。来看看这位 Anthony 大哥在做什么。咦，为什么还要加水？
The ideal conditions inside of the pit are going to be humid, and that humidity is also going to get carried with our convection, right?
Right.
If we were cooking in Houston, it might not be as important because it's already just humid in the air, but especially here, it's not too consistent as far as like temperature or weather.
Replicate the same conditions.
Consistency.
Exactly. Except the meat changes, the wood changes, the weather changes, I change.
Our mood changes.
Exactly.
Are you happy today?
I'm in a good mood today.
Okay, good, happy.
Yeah.
Equals good brisket.
Exactly, hopefully, we'll see. We'll find out tomorrow, really. But yeah, that's all. It's a nice kind of instinctive sort of meditative process of just kind of like figuring out what goes where. I don't think there's any real cooking that like requires as much like personal judgment because it's you, your fires, you're manipulating the meat, like,You're making all of the calls, yeah. To have this sort of top-down presence that can kind of stymie a lot of things.
I like competition cooks, but it's not anywhere near what I do.
It's a different game, right?
Completely different game. It's like what I tell backyard guys, where it's like, I have like 10 feet between my meat and the fire.
Anthony.
Sorry,
you call me chef. I'm like, I'm not used to that.
Do you have IG? Do you have your own IG?
Not really.I kind of try to stay off of it.
Just let the restaurant and like the cooking itself, you know,
it's a big part.
They're the IG. If I want to point out my work, I can always be like, hey, some page with like 100,000 followers, like I cook for them, you know, which is a lot more fun for me. I don't have to broadcast myself.
我告诉你啊，你不要叫他们 chef， 你叫他们 pit master， 这才对哦。
We're hot, pray harder.
You got it. There you go. Watch your step. There you go. Perfect. Right.
真正烟熏才会有这种 pink ring， 粉红色的一圈，它是因为肉缺氧，这个才是真正的 Texas barbecue。现在吃到的是 brisket， 胶质全部都弄出来了，这个就是入口即化。
今天就是亲自呢来到了德州奥斯汀烧烤，非常非常的好吃，所有东西都是新鲜的。牛胸肉是很硬的东西，你知道吗？经过这种长时间熏烤之后，哇哦，入口即化。
You know, Lao Tzu tells us that the rigid often break, so you have to be a little bit flexible in your guides with making barbecue and.You know, I cook barbecue with the Tao. I share copies of the Tao Te Ching with my cooks every Christmas, the ones that don't have them yet. And we look at the similarities of how he looks at nature and the way fire just happens and the way you don't try to control it, but you just guide it. And different decisions are made throughout the cook with that type of mindset.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you, Pitmaster.
Yeah, you're welcome. Thank you.
Thank you.
家里面有1000大轮的大型烟熏炉，该怎么烟熏出美味的牛肉呢？我们今天来到德州牛肉协会，看有没有办法学到一些独家小撇步。美味的烟熏牛肉当然从最好的食材开始，先示范如何从整块沙朗 sirloin 分切出适合烧烤的 sirloin cap 臀肉上盖。这条鸡肉是 bicep femoris 骨二头肌，和它上面连接一起的另一条鸡肉，肉的纹路刚好相反。我们今天秀肉师最喜欢处理这个部位，因为只要找到两块肌肉之间的缝隙，就可以很轻松地把它们分开。你看，简单又漂亮。现在手上这块是 sirloin cap， 纹肉上盖，可以说它是牛的屁股，有带指盖的叫做 cap on。 你可能听过著名巴西烤肉，它叫 picanha， 也叫 cula 或上腰肉，十分的美味。接下来把厚的结缔组织全部都去掉，记得要修干净哦。今天我们要整块烟熏这块 cula 肌肉，会修掉一些脂肪盖，这个步骤叫做 T 脂 denuding。 这边才修好肉，在一旁其实肉都已经烤好了，它烟熏了一个半小时。肥肉当然是要留下，如果把肥肉去掉，烟熏的过程会快一点。看起来就很好吃，赶快来切吧。烟熏库拉臀肉上盖是用这个简单的炭火烤炉改装成的烟熏炉烤的，先把炭放在一边，烧成灰白后再加上木块，今天用的是山核桃木 Hickory Wood， 直接放在炭上面。另一边放一个水盘，里面加了一些水，你可以用任何液体甚至啤酒都可以，但是会觉得有点浪费吧。准备好炭和木块之后，确认通风口有足够的空气流通，然后就让它开始烟熏。第一个小时后开始检查食物，它通常会等到华氏130度，也就是摄氏54度中心温度再取出，然后让它静置休息一下，中心温度会持续上升，变得更熟一些。
Smoke follows beauty, okay?
美国人超爱烤肉，他们房子大院子也大，各种家用的烟熏炉满天飞，绝对不是你在 Costco 常看到的那些哦。想知道德国牛仔如何生火吗？不同的木头会烟熏出不同的风味，这跟产地也有关系。
So this is your Central Texas barbecue that you will find like briskets and all that in town. In this particular world, they use post oak a lot. Okay, this is a nice kind of a neutral flavor profile. It's not overpowering, but it gives it a point.
再用 para burner 这种大喷枪来点火，这可不是你印象中的喷枪哦。没错，超酷的。
Normally there wouldn't be a fire, there'd be more wood.
当木头烧尽变成灰白色，再放入烟熏炉。现在来介绍四种家用烟熏炉。 Offset Smoker 侧火式烟熏炉，大部分人在德州用的都是这种侧火式烟熏炉。这种烟熏炉的火势通常位于烹饪区的一旁，让热源和烟雾从侧边进去进行间接熏烤 indirect heat。 有些型号还有个保温区，可以用来放食物甚至烤马铃薯。主烟熏区的温度通常在摄氏107到120之间，而保温区的温度大概在摄氏65到80，所以根据你放食物的地方温差会很大，你可以依照你的需要把食物放在不同的位置来控制火候。
Things in here, if you need more heat, you can move it closer. You can kind of move it down if you want to take away the heat. So you got some nice options with something this big and all that.
Vertical smoker, 直立式烟熏炉，这台叫做 The Vault 或 The Safe， 外形就像一个保险箱，因而得名。它的保温效果十分的好，你要注意加多少木头，因为很容易过热。这类烟熏炉的设计是箱型的，里面有三层烤架和一个挡烟板，将可以让热量和烟雾更均匀的分布。这里是你的烹调区域，进气口控制空气流量，热气会从两旁的排气口排出。你还可以放水盘来增加湿度，防止肉变干。Kettle style vertical smoker， 水壶型垂直熏炉，它的外观像是一个加高的水壶型烤炉，但内部设计成直立式结构，让你能在多层烤架上同时熏烤不同种类的食物。它是非常适合家庭使用的全能性烟熏炉。绰号 R2D2 的这款小型烟熏炉，它高高圆圆的外观看起来有点像星际大战里面的 R2D2， 也是一种水壶型垂直烟熏炉，它小巧可爱，适合家庭使用。 Pellet Smoker 木颗粒电子烟熏炉是一种方便又实用的烟熏炉，具有电子控制温度的功能，可以让你设置好了就不用管了， Set it and forget it。 因此也被人称为懒人烟熏炉。你只要设置好温度，它就会自动调整，让你轻松腌制出美味的食物。这款烟熏炉大约可以容纳15磅的木颗粒 wood pellets 作为燃料，温度波动不会超过华氏10度。底部还设有一个防护罩，方便清理。虽然燃烧木颗粒的熏炉，它的烟熏味可能没有传统烟熏炉那么的强烈，但调整适当，还是能达到理想的烟熏效果。虽然这些庞大的烟熏炉在台湾公寓可能不太实用，但是人人都爱美食，用嘴巴、眼睛都可以吃。让我们来 enjoy 今天这顿另类的美式牛肉下午茶吧。晚餐来到 Salt Lake Barbecue 的 Driftwood 原始店，它以满满乡村风的气味和招牌烧烤闻名。当年它只是一个路边的小吃摊，每天卖完就收工。如今不仅成为连锁帝国，连机场都插旗了。现在的它是否仍保持初衷，还是成了地雷店？一进去看到29.99美元吃到饱，折合台币1000元左右，让我开始有点担心。虽然牛胸肉、猪肋排、香肠全都有，听起来很划算，但是这样会好吃吗？一进门就被他们庞大的 smoke pit 烟熏烧烤坑震撼到。烧烤坑用木头直火加热，已经烟熏好的牛胸肉经得起这样的加热保温吗？看到员工拿着像拖把一样的大刷子涂酱汁在烤肉上，但是德州式的烟熏烧烤好像不应该边烤边涂酱吧。他们说自己其实是 South Carolina 南卡罗莱纳州风的烧烤 BBQ， 所以会边烤边涂酱，还特意带我们去参观他们的烤炉。你看看，牛胸肉正悠哉的在 rotisserie 旋转炙烤架上转啊转，看起来十分的专业。但是重头戏还是要看味道，好不好吃才是最重要。当我们动了筷子，哦，不是动手之后，期望变成失望。猪肋排还行，但牛胸肉真的太干了。
今天这一家 Salt Lake， 跟我们早上吃的那家 Styles， 你喜欢哪一家？
早上，
我也是。
早上那一家是他们很专注，只是做这些，而且他们用的全都是 prime， 跟一般的有差。
可能是在那壮观的烟熏坑里面待了太久，差点成了烟熏风干牛胸肉了吧。你可知道除了玉米，美国牛也有隐藏菜单，让大理石油花更漂亮。
这是什么？这就是牛吃的，不是只有玉米，主要在这边就是要比较高的蛋白质。
这位颜值超标的正港德州牛仔负责管理这个饲养场，这里像是牛的饭店，包吃包住。所以这到底是什么？
It's a very high protein coming in from the brewery. I mean, it's over 30% protein.
牛仔牛断奶后，接下来需要快速成长，食物要含丰富的蛋白质。
闻起来就像发酵的啤酒味。
这个是 Budweiser 来的，百威牛。
百威牛。
百威啤酒。
啤酒剩下的渣也有放在里面。所以有些麦嘛，还有一些黑麦啊什么麦。
最后的六个月是肥育牛阶段，这时牛主要摄取高淀粉的玉米，以便迅速增重。
So that's where your corn is your main, your steam flake corn is your main ingredient in those rations, because you're trying to get them good and fat.
玉米啊，搅碎全部碎的玉米。美牛最爱吃这个的。
来，我们看到这些牛会被一区一区的围起来，这就是一个 customer， 就是他们这边的他自己的牛。那通常他们的这个牛的年纪要差不多，因为他们这样在喂食的时候也比较方便。
德州的天气炎热，不耐热的安格斯黑牛通常会和耐热的牛种混种，例如这里看到的背上有驼峰的美国 Bremen 牛。当然最多的还是以安格斯为主的混种牛。 也有 F1 等级的美国和牛。
今天呢，我们就来到一个专门培育恩格斯牛的一个Mr. Body 先生他的农场。他说他卖的这个牛啊，主要就是恩格斯牛。我们后面那些是母的，他的公牛全部今年都已经被卖光了，所以呢，他每年都要培养出好的牛，才可以卖给其他人。
那这些用来繁殖交配的纯种恩格斯牛，到底一只要多少钱呢？
There's some very wealthy people in this world that play in the cattle business as a sideline, kind of like racehorse people, you know? And money is no object to them. They go to one sale and they have a good buddy that's selling some really, really special bull. And it's not uncommon for some of those bulls to bring $300,000-$500,000 at a sale.But it's also very likely that the guy that buys that one has a sale 2 months later and his buddy comes back and buys his bull for $500,000. So it really can be a money trading deal.
但是 Mr. Body 比较实在，他不玩那些炒作的金钱游戏。他说他的公种牛每只平均大约$70,000+。你们真的很好命啊。
好，我们今天要来另外一家 Terry Black。Barbecue，
最后一站，
最后一站，今天已经吃了快连续三天了吧？不知道这一站最后一家怎么样？Let's go！
来到名店 Terry Black Barbecue， 当然也要参观一下他们的烟熏烧烤区。打开来看看，烟熏牛胸肉正在熏烤当中。他们使用的烟熏炉一样是改造自1000加仑的天然瓦斯桶。他们说已经烤了9个小时多了。牛胸肉的边缘比较薄的部位，他们有包上铝箔纸，让它不会烤过熟。快要大功告成喽！后面的静置和保温过程一样的关键，才能确保最终的肉质口感完美。
About 200 degrees internally, and then we'll have them sit out here and they'll rest until they come to about 165 inside, 155 to 165. Then they get wrapped in foil and we put them in the shams in the back. They hold at 145 overnight until they're ready to serve. So they stay fresh until they're ready to serve. They're not refrigerated or anything. Yeah.
Beef ribs, brisket, pork ribs.
Thank you. 首先当然就是牛胸肉 brisket 很漂亮的 pink rib 牛小排，烟熏牛小排，你看，哇，汁这么的漂亮。这边也是牛小排，但是它就是 burnt end， 它叫做 candy， 这样子，就是经典的德州 barbecue。
吃一下，今天最后一家 Terry's Black， 这个是 brisket。
看到红色吗？
这家绝对比昨天好吃很多。牛小排带骨的，你不会是过软，然后也不会太干 ，juicy。哇，这家还不错。哇，
它没有就是 spoil off the bone， 但是它就是。胶质都软化了，
看，我看到胶质，
这边有没有？
都胶质，都软化掉了。你觉得怎样？这家牛小排很棒 ，Terry Black's， 值得前来。
今天是我们这一趟旅行的最后一站，非常完美的结尾。Terry Black's 的 BBQ， 如果你在德州 ，Austin 一定要来。
这次在德州，我觉得。最好吃的 brisket 烟熏牛胸应该是在 Styles， 但是最好吃的烟熏牛小排 short ribs 一定是在这里。
Terry Black's，
拜
拜拜。